year ago in Tallahassee, the Florida State Seminoles rose like a phoenix to score 28 points in the final quarter for a 31-31 tie with the Florida Gators. That was enough to take your breath away, and we're about to do it again 1 year later. Sports College Football presents, in cooperation with the CFA, the Florida State Seminoles and the Florida Gators. And here are the Gators, ranked third in the national polls, undefeated with 10 wins, will play next week for a third straight SEC championship. But the opponent this week is number 6, Florida State. Thus, there is a degree of uncertainty that goes with the matchup.
Number 19, Ike Hilliard, and number 12, Jaquez Green, are deep to receive the football for the Gators. They're in the home colors. Florida State, Scott Bentley will kick it off. They're in the white shirts, and we're ready to play a big one. And here comes Green for the Gators, getting a block on the corner and finding a crack that gets him all the way across the 45 and out to about the 46. As Danny Werfel, who's tearing up the record books, comes out. You can see what he has done in 1995. Gators, and Werfel hunkers down. Here we go with it. Little quick pop to the left side over to Hilliard. Hilliard finds room, fumbles the football, and the Seminoles recover it. So Florida State comes up with a loose ball. Danny Cannell is the senior quarterback. Look at his accomplishments for the year. 31 touchdowns behind Cannell. And from the 36, Cannell throws same kind of a play. And it's swung out to a running back, Warwick Dunn. And Dunn will... The Chili starting lineup. Warwick Dunn is an exceptional persona in this ball game because he can do so many things. The first down marker in place, and the chain is all tangled up. The officials haven't seen it yet. Back goes Cannell, throws, and the ball is deflected as it passes.
Rushing for the second consecutive year, and he's caught 39 passes.
Quickly to the attack on second down and 10. The ball is thrown to Andre Cooper, number 1, the junior from Jacksonville. The offensive front is anchored by Clay Shiver, number 53, 280-pound senior. First down, Florida State, trying to strike quickly off the turnover. No pretensions at running here. Penalty flag thrown.
Pass interference on the defense. First down.
They put it on the 31-yard line and make it a first down and 10 for the Seminoles.
Mark Campbell there is a top defensive lineman. He's got a little knee problem today, wearing a brace.
Out of the shotgun, air ball, they call it. The ball is batted down at the line of scrimmage. The defensive backs include Fred Weary, who got flagged a moment ago. The other cornerback is Antoine Lott. You see that Lawrence Wright and Lott... You've got to do something quickly because the Gators are coming. The pass is away. It's over the head. Cooper spent on the season and third down conversion. It is third and 10. Pitch it out to Dunn. Gets a little help from the tight end over there, and he's going to come up short of his first down. And here are his numbers for 95. He's hit some bumps in the road at Tallahassee, but he's seemingly put everything back together. His longest field goal this season, 34. This one is from 40. There's plenty of leg on it. And it's good. So Florida State gets on the scoreboard off the turnover to lead 3-0. We've yet to have a running play in the ball game. Here's a high hanging kick now. And this is Green. He's one of the special team stars for the Gators, and he is rolled out. The Chili starting lineup for the Gators. The backs and receivers include Chris Dory, who is not recruited yet. On first down from the 21-yard line, Werfel looks and throws quickly, and the pass is complete. That's 9 plays in the ball game. The offensive front is led by big Jason Odom. He started ever since he showed up on campus. He's 298 pounds, and that whole offensive front is plenty good.
Awful good offensive line.
Ball is at the 33-yard line for the first down for the Gators, and Werfel turns, gives to the running back. Voila! We have a running play as Elijah Williams stumbles and falls at midfield. Gets quiet when the Gators have the ball, and Danny Werfel back looks down the middle, goes short instead. He had Doering down the middle of the field, but took the short man. Led by Andre Wadsworth, they're all good. Woolware, but they're also dinged up a little bit up front. Tarrant Marion and Orpheus Roy, but three things. He's big, he's strong, and he's quick.
He's agile, and he gets around.
And indefatigable. Down the middle this time with a pass. It is caught by Dwayne Mobley, the fullback, out of the backfield.
Samari Rowe is the top defensive back in that secondary. He comes in with three interceptions, even though they lead the ACC in pass defense.
At the line of scrimmage. And there's contact along the line of scrimmage as the ball is handed away to Williams. And a penalty flag is thrown by both the linesmen. Yes.
Offside on the defense. 5 yards. Still first down.
As Florida State leads off their first possession and the Florida turnover, 3-0. Gators now mounting a threat. Werfel has the ball
nice
slapped
play.
Right back in his face. Second down and 5. Pressure coming. Down he goes. Sam Coward with a sack. And it's third down and 15. Werfel getting pressure from the backside. Caught again. Number 55 shot in there and got his miss. Stevenson is in the punt for the Gators. D. Feaster is back to return it for Florida State. It's a low kick that's going to bound around, and he'll let it roll, and he should not have, because the ball rolls all the way back to with Danny Connell at quarterback. And they've yet to run a running play. The ball is thrown incomplete, intended for Melvin Pearsall. Here's the first running play of the ball game for the Seminoles, and it's who else? Warwick Dunn. It is third down and 2. Dunn again. Won't get to the corner. Good defensive play. Over 43 yards to punt. Normally gets a lot of wind under it, and he's got a howitzer shot that runs Riddell Anthony all the way back to the 28-yard line. But gets a little block on the corner, and with his quickness is able to come back close to the 45. And Terry Jackson is in the backfield. Three wide outs. And it on the play coming around to Jacques Green.
Every trick that's ever been invented on an offensive side of the ball, these two teams have it.
Second down and 6 as Danny Werfel gets protection. Throws a little bit behind the intended receiver.
It wears him out.
It is 3rd and 6. Pressure coming. Gets away. Got a first down. Danny Werfel runs for a first down. Stretching. Just inside the 42, he hands the ball away to Jackson. And Terry Jackson throws some power running as he hammers his way down to about the 23-yard line. First down for the Gators. 6:10 remaining in the first quarter. Florida State leading 3-0. Gators are threatening. Got a man in the end zone. Touchdown. Chuck Green for the touchdown. The extra point try by Edmiston is good. And so the Florida Gators get their first points of the day at 6:04 to go in the first quarter, and they lead 7-3. Guys moving around. Here's the kick. Feaster, freshman out of Rockville, South Carolina, gets to the 15, and he's taken down at the 16. And Goodell sets him up. He throws to the sideline, and the pass is dropped incomplete.
Finally, another backup offensive lineman also getting in early in the game.
Warwick Dunn.
Great tee snap.
Third down and 2. They throw for it. The pass is good to Cooper. Andre Cooper is up to the 35-36.
Because of all the throws that are going to be made today.
Now they're in the shotgun. The snap is quick and sharp, and he hands it off to Warwick Dunn. Dunn wriggles around for a yard or so, and that's all. Lock Preston, a running back, is now in the slot. Dunn goes in motion. That gives them five wide out. Connell passes away. The pass is good to Cooper. He is just short of a first down.
Let alone making the snaps for the quarterback.
3:32 to go in this first quarter, and Connell is belted behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards. Riddell Anthony is waiting to return it. Another beautiful punt. Anthony calls fair catch, and he decides, what am I doing? I'm on the 10-yard line. Let it go, and here he comes again. And he's back to throw. There's pressure coming, and he loops his snap over the head of Terry Jackson.
Now, Rebo is 22nd birthday.
Pass away, and it is worth 6 inches. Defense wins big ball games. Third down, and still about 10. Pressure up the middle, and Sam Howard with his second sack at the 4-yard line. His first kick today was a 44-yarder. This one is not very good. It's fielded this time by Pete Feaster, and he's going to give the Seminoles a first down. The Florida 25-yard line. Bell sets him up. Dunn is the deep man. Dunn skipping into the middle of the line will take it down to the 20. Second down and 4. Joe Blitz. Ball given off. Dunn is decked. What? 5 receivers spread out. One of them is Dunn. Gets some pressure. Passes away into the end zone. It is incomplete. It was intended for E.G. Green. Scott Bentley is in for a field goal try. And it looks like it'll be 38 yards. Travis Chambers puts it down. It's got enough leg on it, and it's good. So with 27 seconds to play in the first quarter, Scott Bentley has his second field goal of the day. The first one from 40, this one from 38. It's 7-6, Gators.
In the third quarter against Florida State. Oh, yeah. Warm out for the fourth quarter.
High hanging kick. And it's Jacquez Green. He's a burner. And he doesn't mind working in traffic. Now behind Danny Werfel.
That was Ron Zip talking to a troop.
And this is Jackson. And he runs into a crowd after a pickup into the quarter. And after one, it's Florida 7 and Florida State 6. Second down and 8. Ball is at the 27-yard line. Werfel is back, and he's looking around, lets it go, and he's got his man.
Nice throw.
Right in the middle of a whole bunch. First down and 10. Seminoles may have been in the neutral zone. Here's a big play for Terry Jackson. And
pretty pleased with the results, and looking forward to getting back to work.
Hold on for a second. We'll be right back.
Werfel lets it go, Pete. Doring is under. 15-yard penalty.
Him, of course, was a great start to University of Florida before he started playing on Sunday.
Werfel back, loops it to the sideline. The ball is caught by Anthony. Riddell Anthony goes out of bounds beyond the first down marker. He leads 7-6 as we start play here in the first minute of the second quarter. Werfel back, looking around, lets it go underneath. Ball is caught to pick up to Jackson.
Three-man defensive line.
Deep. 17-yard line, first down. Connell throws it out to Dunn. There's a Gator out there to get a hold of him, and they take him down at the 20. Kevin Long is doing the snapping, and Connell throws, and the ball is incomplete, intended for Melvin Pearsall.
We just got to keep playing hard.
Third down and 7. Connell lets it go deep. Here's Cooper running under it, and the pass is incomplete. Maybe intercepted.
Yes.
There's a penalty flag, however, dropped.
Pass interference on the defense. 15 yards. Previous block. First down.
As Florida State comes to the line of scrimmage, Connell turns, hands the ball away. No daylight in the middle. They roll him back. Second down and 8. Done again, and he's a yard short of his first down.
By handing it to him or by throwing it to him, more possession to him.
Third and 2, and he's looking for first down, and he won't get it. As Dexter Daniels, the third time. First 2 were really big. This one is sliced off the side of his foot, but he has a pretty good roll on it, and it'll roll dead at about the 16-yard line. Elijah Williams and Dwayne Mobley are in the backfield now, and that's Green going in motion with Werfel back to throw. He goes deep to the sideline, and the pass is incomplete, intended for Jacques Green. Riddell Anthony is the man in motion. They'll run it with Williams. He is their leading running back. Third down and 7. Werfel's pass is underneath to Hilliard. He's got a first down and more as he goes all the way to the 43-yard line.
He picks up a lot of yardage.
Came into this ball game with 44 catches for 691 yards, so he averages better than 15 yards per catch. This is Elijah Williams. And Huskers beating Oklahoma 37-0 yesterday. That pass is thrown with a lot of spin on it. And good. Werfel back, drops it underneath again, and it's another first down as Tremaine Allen, the tight end. First down at the 44, Florida State. Werfel, that's
a pass.
As Doring puts it in the air, too long, it's intercepted, but he is out of bounds. Second and 10. Sam Howard.
No backs in the backfield. 5 wide receivers. There's a blitz.
They're going after him and knocking off balance. Yep. Force him to pull it down, and he's taken down. Loss of 10 will cut it away. And this time it's a good one as Robbie Stevenson knocks it dead down at the 5. As the crowd jumps all over Florida State's offense as they come up to the ball. It's throwing to the sidelines. An incomplete E.G. Green, intended receiver. Second down and 10. They go to gun this time, hit behind the line of scrimmage, but gets loose. And it gets about 8 yards out. Dangerous down at the end of the stadium. And he's got to hurry. And whistle. And they...
Dead ball. Delay of the game. On the offense.
Yeah.
That'll
fall. Now lets it go deep, and it's over everybody's head. The crowd really bothered.
Yes.
Now he's got a low line drive. That's not a particularly good kick because it's taken off the bounce by Riddell Anthony, and he's collared and taken down at the Florida State.
Head ball.
Fighting.
Personal foul on the kicking team.
So the foul of watching Ohio State play Michigan. So it'll be an entertaining halftime for you. Werfel back. Good protection. Now he runs out of time. Down he goes. Second down and 18.
That's where quarterback draws.
This time they pick up Power. Throw the ball. He likes Hilliard. Hilliard gets loose and he's on his way for a touchdown. Great run by Hilliard. He was patient. He let it happen. Hilliard waited for help to come, got there, and he took it in.
He made his career in the beginning, really turned his play around.
You mean Danny Cannell?
Yeah, Cannell, I'm sorry, excuse me.
5 yard line. Picked up by D. Feaster. He finds a little daylight and gets out across the 20. They've handled him so far today. Cannell looking around, throws underneath. The pass is poorly thrown. It helps the people. That is difficult for them. This ball is thrown to number 89, Wayne Messam. Here come substitutions on the field at the last second. They've got 10 seconds to get it off. And they go to the big back, Hubert Williams, the two. They got Hubert lined up in there at a slot. There's a potential receiver, and he's open. He throws it to him, but he waited a little bit too long.
Didn't put anybody out there and waste a guy covering him.
Second down and 10. That pass is thrown underneath the coverage up to the 40, maybe the 41. For Florida, redshirt freshman out of Spring Hill. On third down and 3. Incomplete pass, pay for Sean List. Gators go after it. He gets it out of there, and it's a good kick. It runs Anthony back inside the 15. He came back to about the 17, and where it's first down for the Gators. Elijah Williams. Big run. The sophomore from Milton, Florida.
No call.
Purple back. Got him in. Chris Doring, number 28. Purple hands the ball off to Williams. Works his way in traffic to the 39.
He's not up there. Florida's kind of taken over this ball game since the beginning of the second quarter.
Purple with a lot of time. Goring down the middle of the field with a 20-yard line and another first down.
Werfel, another big day.
First down just short of the 20. Danny back looking around, goes into the end zone for Goring. Touchdown. That is a Southeastern Conference career record for Chris Goring. Edmiston to the point. Good. Seven, a big first time.
Took him a minute and 10 seconds to score that time.
High pop-up kind of a kick. We're on the 12-yard line for Rock Preston. But he doesn't get a whole lot. 42 picks remaining. Sim Dunn. And he's close to a first down. He's got the ball. He's got the first down. And that'll stop the clock as they move the chains. The first half is done at Florida Field. And the Gators have been dominant, particularly in the second quarter as they scored 21 points and lead Florida State 28-6 at halftime. With Preston and Feaster deep for the Seminoles. Though it has been overcast and cool, it has not rained. It's at the 2-yard line for Rock Preston. He butted heads at the 20 and kept his balance.
He didn't even mention it to his team in halftime, Pete.
Warwick Dunn tries it. Knowles going with no huddle. Out of the shotgun, Danny Cannell, who's not had a big day yet, forces that one in. It is an incomplete forward pass.
And blitzing, but they've also given up some big plays in those blitz situations.
On third and 9, Cannell has nobody to throw it to. That is an incomplete.
One and got 3 points off of it.
Sean List has had a pretty good day punting the ball and has another good one on the way, all the way down to the 25-yard line.
That's probably going to be a pass. Nope.
Elijah Williams. Williams has had a pretty good day so far. Handed away on a ride to the fullback.
through the hands of Elijah Williams. What? Seminoles ought to come out of here with pretty good field position. Easter waiting under, gets to 39, gets to a hole, and gets to midfield, and finally puts it on the Gator side. All right, here come the Seminoles now. First down at the Gator 49-yard line. They got a problem, and part of the problem has to do with things like that. Here the mix.
Offensively, the Seminoles have not done much today.
That's Ron to Cooper and Andre Cooper. Those are not winning figures.
No, they're not. They're not. Not for Florida State.
Cannell is sacked by Mark Kimball. Can't stand that.
Cannell, first sack for the Gators.
High booming kick into the end zone. It'll come out to the 20, and let's update that Ohio State Michigan.
You get your brains beat out jumping over the top, I want to tell you.
This pass is flipped out to Ike Hilliard
against Arkansas.
Here's Werfel looking around. Here's the difference right there. Werfel had time to look all over.
But faking blitz, and Werfel is saying, all right, I'll change the play here.
I'll give it to Elijah. No, Terry Jackson.
Take over the reins.
Up the middle. Could drive a truck through it. And it's another first down, and there's a penalty flag.
Holding on the offense. 10 yards, spot of the foul. Still second down.
The
dead ball. Encroachment on the offense. 5 yards. Second down.
Second down and 18 or so, at least. That ball is thrown down the middle. I mean, just absolutely perfectly laid into the hands of Ike Hilliard.
Not a strong arm. Very bright and very active.
Now the ball is on the 49-yard line. Seminole side of the field. Junkie Green trying to get around that corner. And number 6, Robert Hammond.
He did not miss a day of practice thanks to this man. Pete?
Suspiciously, huh? Oh, look at this. Wasn't he down? Elijah Williams, the single back. Is Danny Werfel giving some hand signals? Very quiet here in the stadium right now with a record crowd on him. So the Gators have the ball. He cannot deliver it, and the umpire throws a flag.
Forward pass, and it was a blitz.
There's another flag. Low line drive. Deep Easter gets it back across the 25 to the 26. No, it's against the Gators. Boy, they had a terrible series.
They may have been much more productive because he holds the ball a little longer and has been throwing it deep.
Warwick Dunn heading outside. Flips him and gets the first down. That's the best run of the day.
Puts it back. Does not go to tackle him.
Canal goes to the sidelines. Completely. He's out of bounds.
He's way out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
Way out of bounds.
Lightning. Second down and 10. Canal has a man wide open and hits him. Cooper. And Cooper.
Coaches wanted to wear the same pair of pants, the same socks each week, shoes.
Canal looking around and throws it into the crowd. Out of bounds. Second down and 10. Done. He goes. There he goes. Tough run. First down. Seminoles.
That's on the end.
Brock Preston gives him a breather. Has the ball going right up the middle. Inside the 10. Yelling at his pal. Can't play
here
anymore. Bad knee. Goes to Preston. He's inside the 5. He's got a first and goal for Florida State. So it's first and goal. Florida State at the Gator 3. It's done. He's in there. Touchdown for the Seminoles.
Down to the score.
Canal's up under center. Dunn comes in motion, becoming a receiver, and Canal back to throw. Dunn, good. He throws to Green for the 2 points. And it's a 28-14 ball game with 5.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Not too deep. Makes it at the 8-yard line.
conservative on this drive right here. I think you're going to see him open it up again.
Warfield comes out on first down, lets it go down the middle for Hilliard. He's got it. There's your answer. Touchdown. For the point. 35-14 Gators. That is the 70th team touchdown for the Florida Gators this year, which is a season record in the SEC. This is Matt Prescott. Waited too long to commit himself. First down at the 19 now for the Noles as Spinell rolls out, gets his pass off, and he's got a man out there, and he caught the ball. Great catch by E.G. Green, and a first down. First down at the 46 now as the Noles try to come back with another one. This is Dunn. First man got his hands on him, Antone Lockheed, and they don't give him the half a dozen yards that looked like he might have had. He got only two because he hit the chalk. Here goes Dunn the other way. Look at that cut. First down.
Is this kid good or what?
He's already got his degree.
Yes, he does.
On first down, Canero wants to go big. He's got Cooper, and he can't come in with it.
True. Can't run with these guys.
Lock Preston in the backfield. Gets a block for his quarterback. Third and 10. Down the middle. Green caught it and held on.
Great catch.
He's looking all right. Warwick Dunn and Poobear Williams in the backfield. Poobear's in front. Warwick following him on first down. Second down and 6.
Warwick's
gone in there for about a yard. Third and 6. Third and 5, actually. Shotgun for Cannell. Nobody. Nobody. Now he throws it in the back of the end zone. Cooper got a hand on it, but couldn't reel it in.
Dowden decides to go for a field goal here, down 21 points.
Well, it is not a fake, as you might have suspected or have been suspicious of. He knocks it through, and that'll make it a 35-17 ball game.
That speaks very well. He's got a lot of confidence in his offense. He can come back plenty of time to score. But the body is still the same. The head is still the same. If you hit him in the head, you're going to have concussions.
The kickoff by Bentley goes down to the 4-yard line for Green. Pretty good return.
Yeah, give Ron.
Well, last time he went big on the first down. Down the middle. This time he runs it. Goes to Elijah Williams. And a penalty flag. Holding Gators.
And of course, Warfield's had a great day just getting him the ball.
Hilliard.
The rest of the 83,000 start booing.
Danny's got all day.
Same play.
Same play. Same result.
Looked up.
And late goal. That ball goes through the hands of Stevenson and the Seminole clobbering. Back inside the 10-yard line. Warwick Dunn. In the backfield with Poobear Williams as they work out of the shotgun. Cannell. Looking around, he's got Cooper, touchdown.
Cannell's warming up, just like last year. Steve's thinking about it.
1-point drive, Bentley squibbed it through there. Not terribly authoritative, but it was in. Green and Anthony. Green. He's taken. taken down in a hurry by number 52 in the backfield. Oh, that was a left. Oh, he's standing wide open with L. Anthony.
Well, Fred Taylor, another tailback, is out. They've had injuries at that position all year.
This is Jackson carrying, Kerry Jackson. Back for the finish after this message and the word from our ABC station. Second down at 6 for Florida at their own 40. Back goes Danny Werfel. Pressure coming, steps away from it, loops the pass out. Good to Evans. He's wide open. Big play. And the big old fullback puts that ball down inside the 25-yard line. Coming down there on a full head of steam, and Sean Hammond said, I need some help. Pass to the corner for Doring. He's out of bounds. He's out of bounds.
I'm not so sure. He had a step on him. Let's see. Ball, foot, possession?
No.
Huh?
Not when they're doing out of
bounds. I don't know.
Second down and 10. Danny looking at him again. He's got it right through his hand this time. It's still third
right.
down and 10.
They're short in the back position,
too. Is not out there. Yeah,
right.
He's gone.
Right.
Werfel going the other way. See what's over there, and same result. Incomplete.
This is pretty good size, 42 yards. But it's pretty big, too, if he can get it.
Didn't quite get the hand. I don't think the snap and the hold were. All right, first down for the Seminoles, just short of the 25. And Cannell back. Slammed by Hanks. Ben Hanks hammered him in the back. And it's an incomplete forward pass.
Started up. It just started up.
Cannell's pass has got a man over there. That's Cooper. And Cooper's out to the 45-yard line.
They definitely needed the back judge, who was using the field judge, who was usually in the middle of the field.
This is Dunn slicing into the middle for about 5 yards. Nothing doing. Loss of a yard and a half on that last play. Cannell now rolls it out, gets his pass away, and it's completed to E.G. Green. No, they're saying you dropped it.
31-15, Keith.
Spinning, beautiful kick. Back to the 10-yard line where Riddell Anthony. Kerry Jackson is in the backfield. Remember, Elijah Williams may have a separated shoulder. And Jackson will have a yard. Mobley is now at tailback. He's a fullback. He's now at tailback. And Werfel taken down. Inside the 5-yard line. Seminoles trying to hold him, trying to get field position, get the ball back, and Werfel out of his end zone. Goes down the middle of the field and completes the Doring for a first down.
Oh, boy.
The Doring, 112 yards and a touchdown. But he'll not have a bigger one than that. A little option move down the line, and the pitch to Terry Jackson. Florida now starting to eat up a little real estate, and more importantly, take some time off the clock as Kerry Jackson runs for another first down.
And with a Steve Spurrier allowing number 11 to be on the field, I doubt the 22 might ever be retired.
Yeah, I wouldn't think so. He's a pretty good-looking running back, I tell you. They're moving it on the ground. Here's a little option action again going to Jackson, and he will have another first down.
Holding!
On the Gators. Let's update Ohio State, Michigan with John. It is now second down 11 after the holding penalty. Werfel's pass is away to the sidelines, complete. Guess who? 35-24, Gators lead. And Terry Jackson can't get his engine running on that one. Second down. Werfel and Jackson almost run together. Finally, number 85, Andre Wadsworth.
444 yards.
in a game, in this game, for Werfel.
Third and eight. Intercepted. They got in his face. He tried to dump it off, and it is intercepted by Renard Wilson.
Intercepted the ball.
So it's first down at the 41-yard line. And Warrick Dunn will pick up three.
He's giving hand signals to the wide receivers.
Going deep for Cooper. Intercepted on the ricochet by Antoine Lott. And coming back.
Checked off to a streak down the sideline. Looked like that Lott may have interfered with Cooper. Then Cooper may have pushed off.
Come at this point of the ball game, that's just incredible. Florida first down on the 30-yard line. 5 minutes and 20 seconds to play in the game.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. 5 yards. Second down.
Flips it up the field, and it's incomplete, intended for Jerome Evans.
That was his first interception of the year.
We're inside 5 minutes at 4:57. Werfel looking around, is hit from behind. The ball flying around.
I don't know. I think he's going to say that was, I think that was a fumble.
At 4:10. Gets it out, and he did hit a good one. He's run Feaster back up the field. Ball bouncing around, and he has no chance to return it.
Kicked it over his head.
All the way down to the Florida State 17-yard line.
A hole during the kick on the offense.
Well, Stevenson's back in the end zone, hits it on the one, and this is end over end coming up field, and Feaster needs to pick this one up and move it back up the field, and he does.
Penalty for Florida effectively was 39 yards on the penalty, that much of field position.
Pinnell's pass quickly to Preston. And he's taken down inbounds. Pinnell down the middle, too high, intercepted by Mike Harris. That may do it. Florida ball at the Florida State 43. And this is Terry Jackson. Down to the 36. Second down and threes. Florida trying to burn the clock. Give it to Jackson. And he's close. In fact, he's got a first down. Werfel standing, watching it go to 5, 4, 3. Takes it on 2. Gives it to Terry Jackson, and he's cut down quickly.
Watch him run it right down to 2 or 3 seconds. No, he snapped a little earlier.
And the play is behind the line of scrimmage. No remaining backs. Everybody spread out from sideline to sideline as Werfel runs a quarterback draw. And he does not get the first down at Richard. Fourth down, and the Gators are going to go for it at 1:08 to play. And Werfel going for the bundle to Doring. Complete.
We'll have number one versus number two, Nebraska and Florida, if they get by next week, Arkansas.
That's an incomplete forward pass intended for Cooper. Blow just fainted over here, the executive director of the Citrus Bowl, the Florida Citrus Bowl, because they were sitting over there feeling pretty good about Northwestern Tennessee matchup. And now
you're right.
They came from nowhere. Here's the third down and short. And the forward progress looks like it might very well be a first down.
And Ohio State, what about these Florida Gators and Steve Spurrier?
Well, they were expected to be a good football team, and they have been a good football team. They got a lot of talent around here. That pass is intercepted on the ricochet, and the game is over. So you might as well just go ahead. ahead and sit down, son. The party is all in Gainesville as the Gators have defeated a Bowden. That new. Your final score is 35-24.